Hi, it's Barbara Ireland, and I have a question for you. Are you the kind of person that says, I don't care if exercise makes me stronger, healthier, happier, smarter, live longer, and have better sex? It's still drudgery, it's boring, it hurts, and I'm not going to do it. If that sounds like you, and believe me, I have those days too, then I'm going to challenge you in this video to think a little bit differently about exercise so that it becomes a lot more enjoyable. Because what motivates us to take action or inaction on anything are our thoughts and our emotions about it. And anyone in their right mind who's thinking and, you know, connecting exercise with drudgery and pain is definitely not going to take action on it, right? Unless they absolutely have to, because it sounds awful. So to start you off on this, I want to tell you what happened to me last week. I re-injured my wrist, this old injury, and it made it impossible for me to not only lift weights, but to write, which I love, to brush my teeth, or to wash the dishes. I mean, even pulling up my pants was kind of tough, okay? Thankfully, it only took a few days for my wrist to get pretty much back to normal again, but it got me thinking. Life is full of these surprises, these speed bumps that appear out of nowhere, like re-injuring my wrist. And they completely mess up our lives, our schedule, our to-do lists. And you know, it's a really weird feeling to suddenly not be able to do the things that you take for granted that you could do easily before. I mean, suddenly brushing my teeth with my right hand was a joy to me because it just works a lot faster and better. And the very idea of going to the gym and lifting weights sounded mysteriously fun. And honestly, I'd been kind of resisting it for the last couple weeks. These bad types of surprises can be big perspective changers. And the thing is, we don't have to wait until a trauma or a tragedy happens in order to get that perspective. We have that power now. So let's do a little perspective change here. No matter what age you are right now, just imagine yourself at some future point in your life. And at this future time, you're definitely older than you are now. And your body isn't quite the same. It's not what it used to be. And you're even to that point in the progression of your life and the progression of your physical body where you simply can't run anymore. You can't move vigorously enough to cause sweat to appear. You can't lift heavy weights. You're slower and maybe a little weaker. And that, you know, that doesn't mean that your life's horrible by any means, but it simply means you can't do some of the things you used to do with ease. And from the perspective of that future you, think back to the age you are right now in actual reality. And your future you remembering the body you used to have and all the amazing things it could do, even if it does have or did have some limitations. How does it feel to look back at the body you're currently in right now? Looking back on it and maybe wishing you had another day with it or even an hour so you could still run, so you could dance vigorously and wildly and ride a bike and maybe even skip down the street if you wanted to. So back to the present. This future that we visited may be way down the road for you. But the fact is, one day you won't get to go to the gym, even if you want to. You won't get to feel the muscles that are being used and your lungs getting filled with oxygen and your legs running and the sweat pouring down your forehead. Now, this isn't meant to depress you by any means. In fact, quite the opposite. This is a reminder to enjoy the amazing body you have while you can, to get present with the feeling of it. I mean, right now, just take a moment to feel your body from the inside out. Feel its density and its warmth and its existence. Feel your legs and feel the fact that your eyes are actually watching this right now. Feel the air entering and exiting your lungs. And even put your hand on your heart and feel the pulse of that which keeps you alive and existing and living and loving and being. And the next time you start down that same old mind loops road, thinking about exercise as drudgery and pain, try shifting your thought to, hey, wait a minute. This isn't just something I have to do. This is something I get to do because I can. If you like this video, please share it with someone else who you think might get something out of it. And also, please leave a comment below this video. I'd love to know your thoughts on whether you see exercise as a chore or a gift. And if you have any great tips about how to keep us all motivated and into our bodies and cherishing them even more, please share that as well. Thanks a lot for watching.